Hi guys, Skull here. I'm in Darlington. We're going from Darlington to... where are we going? Bishop Auckland. Darlington, very, very famous historic town in the world of rail. Steep history here. So Darlington is a very kind of... I think there's actually a rail museum here in Darlington. Steam and other rail museum, I believe. I've never been to it. But there is a lot of history in Darlington, which I'm sure some of you guys will know much more about than I do. Picked up this scenario on offer over at Just Trains. I'll leave the code in the video description in case you're interested in it. It rides with a few default trains. It also works with one of the Just Trains Class 153. Today we're in a stock Class 166 train. So, you know, if you buy this scenario, you can drive this particular scenario that I'm going to play today. This is a non-timed mission, so I just thought we'd have a look at the sights today, have a look at the scenery, check it out. I think we're due to go through the oldest working railway tunnel under a settlement in the world. Very, very specific, but it opened in 1842. I think it's called the Prince of Wales Shildon Tunnel. Shildon is the fourth stop on here, and I think at Shildon, I think they've managed to put in the Railway Museum. Not sure, we'll have to see when we get down there. This is part of the East Coast Main Line, Darlington to Bishop Auckland. This scenario comes with passenger services, freight operations and steam excursions. A total of 20 scenarios, I believe, in different weather conditions and so on. But I'll tell you what, let's open the door, let the passengers in while we do that. Let's take a look around here. Like I say, this is the stock Class 166, so you know a lot of stuff doesn't work. Obviously the engine starts and do, but you know these buttons up here don't work. Let's put the lights on while we're here. Cool. None of these are operational. There's some stuff behind is not operational. It's a very minimal, you know, if you want more realism in your trains, a little bit like FSX, you've got to go out there and buy something. Just Trains do a Class 153, which is a diesel electric, and it's very detailed. Okay, that means we're good to go, so let's put the reverse into forward. And let's get going. So this is the default Class 166. Ooh. Listen to this. Awesome. Little announcement. I love little touches like that. I thought I'd just play in the default Class 166 because really what I want to do in this one is just have a look at the scenery. Have a look at how detailed this scenario is without introducing other trains into the mix. Okay, we've just had a alarm, which means we may be having to slow down at some point. We've got the combined accelerator here, so forward to accelerate and reverse to brake. Very simple. And it's a summer's day. I think the scenario is called hay fever season. What's it called? Hay fever season, Class 166 day. So not my particular favourite time of year. I suffer from hay fever. I don't know about you. I don't see any... There's a speed limit of 50, but we didn't just get an alarm for no reason. I'm conscious of the fact that... Oh, we've got a 25 mile per hour speed limit coming up, so let's just make sure we don't break that. Well, a quick look at Darlington. Very, very built up, as you would expect for Darlington. Huge amounts of these terraced houses. You tend to get this a lot in the north of England, where a lot of the factories were. Okay, we've got a green signal. A lot of the factories were up in the north of England, and because terraced housing is essentially a very compact form of living, and they were quick to build, quick to erect, fairly cheap, and they also meant that you could get quite a high density of people in one area, so they could all live and work near the factories. And Darlington's no exception. As you can see, lots and lots of terraced houses. You won't be seeing any semis or detached houses around here, I don't think. But you will see a lot of factories. and quite possibly rail factories, although I wouldn't be able to see them unless they're pointed out to me. I wouldn't know they were necessarily a rail factory. Smoke ahead over there on the right, you see it? Looks like we're due to make a stop here. What's this station? North Road. I'm not going to accelerate, although I could. Okay, don't panic. Let's bring the speed down a touch. It's a beautiful day. I can almost imagine myself sneezing if I was outside. Come on, brakes, kick in. There we go. Let's try not to break the speed limit. Seems to be a bit of a delay on this train when you go to brake. Same when you accelerate. Should we stick our head out the window? We always like sticking our head out the window. So we cruise in over the bridge down the high street. Now, what is the delay on these brakes, I wonder? Oh, this is an interesting setup. Are we supposed to stop before this? Or after it? I'm going to go down here. I'm not exactly sure where we're meant to stop. Let's have a look at the back. Well, the whole thing's on the platform. So I assume that's correct. Why is there a split here? What's the gate for? Well, people can walk through walls anyway, by the look of it. So I don't think a gate... He just walked straight through that wall. Look at that. I don't think the gate's going to stop them, do you? Nope, she just walked through the gate as well. DIY Hub Warehouse, blatantly in a B&Q style logo. That must be a B&Q. Look at all this. This is ridiculous. They've got all of the chimney stacks blowing smoke. Now, you know, if you'd have gone back 100 years, it would have been doing exactly that. All these chimneys, everybody burning coal fires. Which is what they did. But these days, you've got to burn clean. You can burn coal, but most houses don't. And the ones that do tend to burn clean. What's it called? Clean burn coal or something. It's got a very low smoke value. But I don't think we'd be seeing rows and rows of houses. You know, you might see the odd one, but this, I mean, you know, it's obviously meant for a bit of scenery and stuff. Whoa, let's not break that 20 limit. Typical commuter train in the UK, very typical design of a commuter train. They tend to be either electric, which is the ones I used to get into London, or they'll be like this, diesel electric, where there's no power lines for them to use. But the styling is still very much the same. Whereabouts is the diesel? A diesel seems to be on the second engine by the sound of it, on the second carriage. An underslung diesel engine. Very compact. Only three carriages though. I would have thought we'd have had four, but then judging by that last platform, maybe they're all quite short. Bloody look at that bus! I'm doing 30. What speed's the bus doing? Down the bloody road. There must be a 30 limit down there. Crazy, man. Let's pick the speed up. How far is it to the next station? 3.62 miles. We're about to go past another train. Diesel locomotive. Give them a toot. Yep, there you go. I love those diesel locomotives. I wish this thing was... Whoa, hang on a minute. Oh, he's parked in the sidings. I thought his track had ended all of a sudden. He was actually parked in the sidings. That's okay. This is a very nice view. Two more buses over there. What's this, a caravan park? It's a caravan park. Not really a holiday park, is it? More of a gypsy site, as we call them. Let's zoom right out. Let's have a good look at the scenery. It's not bad. Not bad. It's not quite FSX, but... No, I'm teasing. It's pretty good. They've put some good touches in here. Including a crane that's about to unearth the pylon and bring all the power down. in Darlington. Nice touch. Far too many buses on this route for my liking. Let's get back in the cab. Let's see how many buttons are actually in operational use. Most of them are not. What's that one? Sander. Engine start. None of those. Very minimal. So yeah, apparently this includes the Locomotion Railway Museum at Shildon, which apparently houses a large number of steam and diesel locomotives, as well as numerous old freight wagons. So if you're a bit of a rail fan, you might want to take a trip up to Shildon and to Darlington. There's lots to see there. Museums galore, apparently. And I'm trying to remember now, Stockton to Darlington Railway. Wasn't that where Stevenson's Rocket first did his trials? I seem to remember that, Stockton to Darlington. Was that where he set his record? I think that's the kind of history we're talking about, early 1800s. Could be wrong on that. But that my memory kind of kicks in there and thinks that's true. Let me know if you think that's true or not. Nice detail. Nice reasonable amount of detail. I'm not sure which motorway that is. Is that an A road or a motorway? Not sure what that is. Possibly a motorway. I'd have to have a look on Google Maps to see. It's a pity we can't bring up just Google Maps here. Just overlay it. Apparently it's got something built in to do with that, but I'm not exactly sure how you operate it. I don't know why the limit's 40 here. Or 45. Kind of feels like we could go a bit quicker. Maybe 60 or something. Now I'm going to end up speeding, you watch. Let's see if that works. Right, can't be that far away now. 1 mile. Here we go. How do we even say that? Hayington. Hayington? I'm speeding now. I knew I'd end up speeding. I'm going to start slowing down, I think. Very countryside-esque station and route so far. Start shaving that speed off for a half a mile away. Time to put the head out the window. What a lovely day. Making a video like this in the middle of winter kind of feels slightly surreal. I've overbraked it a little bit. I should probably start braking at about about 0.3 of a mile out. Slowed down way too early. Not to worry, better than overshooting. It's usually good to play a new scenario on a non-time setup like this before you have a go in career mode, just to get used to it a little bit. Ooh, it's a level crossing. Cool. Doors open. Let's have a look at this level crossing. Nice. I wonder if any of you guys actually been here. That is really detailed, isn't it? Hayington. Love it. Somebody spent some time laying this out. I only hope it's accurate. I like the way the car has to wait for us as well. What's everybody doing inside? Wow, it's quiet in here. Okay, let's get a move on. Let everybody know we're going. The wipers work, yes they do. Do not trespass on the railway, penalty £1,000. And possibly your life. Bye bye, Hayhinton. I'm not exactly sure what that town's all about. Looks like it's got factories though. Actually, looks like it's got a lot of factories. Good grief. Next stop, Newton Aycliff in 1 mile. Narrowly avoided speeding. What's that on the left? Is that a post office van or something? Should have stuck my head out the window and had a look. This looks very industrial. I wonder if this is scenery built into the train simulator game, or whether Just Trains has built their own scenery and they kind of drop this stuff into their scenario packs. I would suspect the latter. You can kind of see the reuse of these various pipes here again and again and again and again. So, but nevertheless, it has a pretty cool effect. What are you doing? Slacking off, having a fag? Cheeky. I'm sure they're having a business meeting. Not. Okay. We are 0.2 of a mile away, which means I should probably start slowing down. I don't want to overbrake this one, if at all possible. Just past this tunnel, I think, so we better start braking. Bridge, not tunnel. Yeah, cool. This looks a bit better. Easy on the brake. No, we don't want to rev the engine. That's ridiculous. She's stood in the ground. Wet concrete woman. That's an impressive trick, love. How do you do that? That is just brilliant. They're all doing it. He's just walking around. Look at this. Just wading through wet concrete. What's that in the field? Oh, do you hear that? You can hear all the birds tweeting. Nice. Is everybody on and off yet? I don't know why you're all getting off here. There's nothing here. I think he's waiting for the next train. He doesn't want to get on my train. Right, next stop, Shildon. Now, Shildon's the one that has the museum, I think. Two miles to Shildon. Let's get a move on then. Full throttle it. Zoom down here. The lighting's good, isn't it? It really has the feel of a kind of a slightly cloudy summer's day. Look at the ground. You see the kind of shadow on the floor. It's ever so slightly soft. Which is what you'd expect. Miles. Looks like a lot of scenery here. Looks like we've got basically pockets of detail. Darlington was incredibly detailed. And then that Hayhinton, I love the level crossing there. I'm looking forward to this tunnel, the Railway Museum at Shildon, and the 3/4 mile tunnel which we're going to hit at some point. That should be coming up pretty soon. Other than that, it just seems like British countryside with a balloon. You better keep that balloon away from these power lines. That could go very badly for him. Not seen any trains coming the other way yet. There was a train in the sidings, but I've not seen anything coming the other way. I would have expected to see a return journey, don't you? You know, like our opposite number working the track the other way. But no, I've not seen anything. 30 speed limit coming up. But 50%, see if we can shave the speed down. It's all about judging it at the end of the day, isn't it? If you want, because ideally you want to be coming along here and then just hit 30 as you're going through that speed restriction. But to do that, you really have to get used to the train that you're driving. You've got to learn its capabilities. Every train is so different. Like, some of them are, you know, quicker to brake, some of them quicker to accelerate and so on. And until you've learned that, it's not really worth trying it on career mode, because you'll, especially if it's a tight timetable. Oh wow, look at this, this is the museum. Look at that. Awesome. You can actually, look, they've got little things you can get up and go and actually get inside the carriage, probably. And a steam train. Wicked. Look at all that. Fantastic. Whoa, let's be careful. I'm about to overshoot my platform. Too busy looking at the scenery. Shildon. Very, very detailed. Looks like at 50% is quite a decent brake rate if you're just on a steady breakdown anyway. 15. Welcome to Shildon. Population, same people in Darlington. I think you'd tend to see more kind of, because the guy in the suit there looks more like a commuter to me. Him. I don't think you'd see many of those. I think you'd see more people just, you know, on holiday, day tripping and stuff. But that, I'm quite impressed with that platform. It's very detailed. And the museum on the way in, that was kind of cool. Look at him with his legs! He didn't just put his feet in wet concrete, he put his entire legs in it, thighs and everything. Okay, next stop is our final destination. So, we're due to go through that tunnel, aren't we? This better happen. Doors are closed. There's a workman. Don't see many of those. I'm pretty certain he should have got on this train. She's just thighing it through the concrete there. Mate, I think you just missed your train. Bit late now. Oh well. Nothing you can do about that. Right, we've got a 30 restriction here, and then a 45. There's the tunnel. Here it is. Can you see it? Those markers down the bottom? There it is. So this is the Prince of Wales Shildon Tunnel, the oldest working railway tunnel under a settlement in the world. Struggling to see where the settlement is, but this is what the blurb tells us. Oh, look at this, single track. It's a single track tunnel. That's because it's so old and it took such a long time to build a tunnel like this. So they had to put a signal on the front of it. Got a 45 speed limit through here, which means it can accelerate. Cool. Listen to that. Let's blow the horn. Oh, listen to that echo. Awesome. 3/4 of a mile. If you imagine when this was made back in, well, it opened in 1842. You imagine the tools that they had back then. You know, there's no kind of massive bloody boring equipment and JCB diggers. It was people with pickaxes and horses and carts. This would have taken a long time to make this tunnel, and probably people died doing it. But I don't know, you'd have to check out the history of it. Listen to that though. Imagine in the old days as well, when they came through here on a steam train with all the smoke and the steam just in the tunnel, and you're like, in the back of the carriage. Wicked. That was pretty cool. I don't see any settlement though. Is there meant to be a settlement on top there? I would have thought there was meant to be. How far is it to Bishop Auckland? No idea how far it is to Bishop Auckland. Oh, there it is. 1.6 miles. We've got a left turn coming up by the look of it. Very, very nice scenery, very detailed. Obviously put some effort into it. I think my view on it at the moment, bear in mind we're not quite finished, but I'm not sure that I would pay the full price for this. It was 66% off, I think, with the code I used, which brought it down from, I think, £20 to about £8, I think. I definitely wouldn't pay full whack. It's a nice scenery. You know, there are other scenarios, but yeah, it's good, but it's not that good, if you see what I mean. That's my view anyway. But yeah, I do like it. It's a lovely drive. Okay, Bishop Auckland Terminal, 20 miles per hour. Catch more of this scenery. Those houses, they need some like garden textures and stuff, grass and, do you know what I mean? They just look like they're literally plumped on top of the grass, which they are. This is the, if you look, it says Northern Rail inside. This is the Northern Rail livery for the Class 166, which, you know, it hasn't cost me any extra. It comes with it. It just basically seems to lift the Class 166 out of the default stock and slap on a Northern Rail livery, which is nice. Alright, let's apply some brakes here. And this is Bishop Auckland. Very built up area. Oh look, police car on the left, see it? These houses have satellite dishes on them as well. That's quite authentic. Now I'm speeding. No, not 100% brake, man. Good grief. My throttle control is all over the place. I'm not used to this train. Signal's green. Oh, speeding again. Another B&Q. Oh, they're getting out the right-hand side. In that case, stick my head out of this window. Another train waiting in the sidings down there. Epic. And that is our final destination, Bishop Auckland. Open the door so everybody can get off. What did you think? I enjoyed it. It was a lovely summer commute. Personally wouldn't pay full price, but check out the video description, because I'm going to leave that link to Just Trains and the discount code. And hopefully you can get the discount as well, depending on when you're watching this video. Anyway, we did it. That was the first scenario in the pack. There are many others, including the freight and steam excursions. different weather systems. But for now, that's job well done.